16 and here to 15. So the women's final will be an all-Chinese affair. And Colin Wilson, how do you fancy Deng Yiping's chances of retaining her title now?
Well, I think she's certainly odds on. Li Ju, we said, was a favourite for the future, but with a three straight victory, 21-7 in the third against Li Ju, Deng Yiping still very much dominant.
OK, Colin, so we reckon that Deng Yiping might be safely through to defend her title. That is taking place, that final, tomorrow. Well, despite the fact that the women's semi-finals was an all-Chinese affair, two Europeans are trying to stop the Chinese domination. In the men's event, Vladimir Samsonov, the number four ranked player in the world from Belarus, he's out to put an end to defending champion Kon Linghui's hopes. And Jan-Ove Voldner, the world number two, well, he's hoping to make it through against Yang Sen, who at 46 in the world is the surprise package in this semi-finals lineup. Well, first to the match between Jan-Ove Voldner and Yang Sen. Voldner won the first two games, 21-17, 21-15. And we're going to join the action at the start of game three. Remember, it's the best of five, and your commentators are Don Parker and Simon Reed.
Third game, serve China. Love, love.
Game three.
This could be a critical moment, actually, for Voldner in the match. He's two games to nil up, and the only weakness I've ever seen in Voldner is times he can lose his concentration a little bit. But semi-final of the World Championships, I'm sure he's going to be completely focused.
2-1.
Good use of the push there from Voldner on the return. Used the wrist, dug underneath the ball. Rocket topspin off the bounce there from Jan. Just caught the edge of the table. But nevertheless, a very fast forehand topspin.
Immense power, topspin as well, and just flicked over the top of Jan's back. The return seemed to be almost off the end of the table, but he was still good enough to pick his own edge.
Again, it's the side spin, hooking the ball, fading the ball, using side spin to take it to extremes on both sides of the table.
6-3.
Topspin on the service, Jan flicking off the end of the table.
In the end by a good deal of fortune.
Topspin there, just catching the top of the net. A desperate lunge from Voldner.
5-6.
Mesmerizing stuff, just a little flick. There's another former world champion, Jorgen Persson, watching on. And who succeeded Voldner as the world champion.
5-8.
Again, heavy backspin on that push return. Yang Sen putting the ball in the net.
Worry grows now for Jan against the serve. Jan is picking up points and he has 4-point advantage. So easy. Phenomenal. And just a little juggling with the foot to embellish it.
amazing football skills here, let alone table tennis skills. What a backhand on the diagonal. And then as the ball goes up, he kicks it up in the air with his foot. I hope Glenn Hoddle's watching.
Impossible to pick. There was a terrific take back, wasn't there? But you still didn't know if he was going to go down the line or across.
Exactly. You can see here that Jansen's not sure. Is he going to go out wide there, wide the other side?
13-6.
And of course, when you're not sure, when there's doubt in your mind, very difficult to react. And then Voldner very rarely misses.
Well played, yeah.
13, China.
All the trickery from Voldner countered there. So he starts his next sequence of serves 6 points adrift.
8-13.
Well played. He's still got his head up. He's still trying everything he knows. Now, wasn't that brilliant?
Full marks to Jan. He's still playing very positive table tennis, looking to get in with that forehand topspin.
That, 10-13.
Stop it.
The reactions are phenomenal here. A rocket topspin from Jan, but the block there from Voldner. Incredible.
Hold, 15-10. Sweden.
Well, a big mistake at an important juncture, and Voldner now has a 5-point cushion plus 5 serves to come. He could be very near victory after these.
16-10.
Backspin on the service, came underneath the ball, very difficult for Jan to see the change in points of contact.
17-10.
Again, the backspin on the serve.
Ruthless.
18-11.
And he hates himself for missing that. What a perfectionist.
11-19.
First sign that Jan just might have resigned himself here. The first sign after what's been an extensive drilling by Voldner.
11-20.
I'm not sure there whether Voldner was inviting the top spin to have a bit of fun at the end of this game. But Jan missing it. Let's wait and see if Voldner wants a bit of fun.
9 match points.
12-20.
A big salute from Voldner's point of view. He doesn't give too much away, but he has performed in unbelievable fashion here tonight.
Yes. so the number two seed takes his place, his rightful place in the final, Jan Ove Voldner of Sweden. And Colin Wilson, Simon Reid described him there as ruthless, and he pretty much looked that way, didn't he, in that game?
He's the most talented player in the world, and I don't think you need me to tell you that, having seen that game. Jan Sen is a fantastic player. It's a semi-final of the World Championships, and Voldner put him away like he just wasn't there.
Well, Jan Sen was a surprise package, as we said, in the semi-finals, ranked 46 in the world, and you come up against somebody like Jan Ove Voldner. How on earth can you play somebody like that?
Well, there is no way to play Voldner when he's playing like that. His hand skill is so much better than any other player in the world, and yet when he wants to go for the shots, he's got as much power as anybody else, so it's very difficult for Jan Sen.
And he does use that power to great effect, doesn't he, Voldner?
That's right. When Voldner's playing, he uses control, but let's have a look at power here. Getting his forehand in, and again, the ball is past Jan Sen, who's one of the best players in the world. He's underranked. You don't get to a world semi-final without being a top player in the world. But Voldner outclassed him.
And he takes the ball so early, it seems, as well, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. He can take the ball very early. He can also go away from the table and take it late. And it's that variation which confuses his opponents.
Well, we talked about his power, but he has great control as well. The combination of the two is fantastic.
Yes, I think if you see this point here, we'll see Voldner is basically playing with Jan Sen.
And great ball control there at the end.
Wonderful football. Yeah, in that case, he just had so much control. He was letting Jan Sen play, and when he finished, Jan Sen had finished hitting the ball, then Voldner was just putting him away.
Well, he has had sparkling form all the way through, really, his games in the singles, hasn't he, Voldner?
Yes, in the last round, if anyone's wondering what happened to Gassien, he was beaten three straight by Voldner, 21-7 in the first. I saw the match in the hall, and Voldner is just playing brilliant table tennis.
From what we've seen there, what are his chances in the final?
Odds on. Odds on.
Really, you'd say that?
Yeah, I don't mind who he plays. He's got to be odds-on favourite. He's playing unbelievable table tennis.
So Jan Ove Voldner is through to the final. Who will he be facing? Will it be Con Linghui, the defending champion, the world number one from China, or will it be the world number four from Belarus, Vladimir Samsonov? You'll find out just after this short break.
The Benson and Hedges Cup. Match after match, ball after ball. The complete picture throughout the tournament. Yeah! Derbyshire versus Worcestershire, Monday morning at 10:55 on Sky Sports 3.
Caesar means more than a tasty meal cooked in its own tray. Much more. It means you care. Caesar, to love him like he loves you.
In Starland, people are made from deliciously light and bubbly chocolate from Milky Way. Here's Bright Star with a bright idea. Milky Way Magic Stars. The magic's in the Milky Way.
Prepare to be electrified. Hitachi Dolby ProLogic televisions with 3DS recreate the effect of cinema surround sound using just four internal speakers. No wires or external speakers. Wall-to-wall sound, not speakers. Hitachi 3DS. Clearly Hitachi.
Just feel the softness. New Formula Organics Root Nourishing Shampoo feels so creamy and luxurious. You'll feel a softness that shines through. New Formula Organics, for softness that shines through.
People try to put us to death.
Talking about my generation.
Just because we get around.
Talking about my generation.
Things ain't too look awful.
Morning.
Morning, Dad.
Oh, yeah. I must sort out that loan. But I can't get to the bank.
Hello!
There's a new convenient way to get an unsecured personal loan.
Call Lombard Direct. Free on 0800 215,000. 24 hours a day.
We have loans from 800 to £15,000 for almost anything. And our rates are low.
One call to Lombard Direct and you're laughing.
To arrange a loan or for more information, call free on 0800 215 000.
This is the slide. To fire the first time, you pull it back like this. That puts a round up the spout.
A company.
21 of our clients are among the nation's top 500 companies.
Bad company.
He's an aggressive, healthy, heterosexual male with a superior IQ of 141.
Dealing.
You'll find $1 million in that bag.
In.
Spend it wisely.
Bribery.
You're drowning in debt, Your Honor.
In blackmail.
He is a nasty piece of work.
In.
Homicide.
In.
Absolute perfection.
Alan Barkin.
Small risk means small profit.
Lawrence Fishburne.
Big risk. Big profit. Point it. And start pulling the trigger, right?
The television premiere of Bad Company, Saturday at 10, the movie channel.
Welcome back. Well, our final semi-final is the pick of the bunch. It's the world number one and the defending champion, Con Linghui of China, against the man that many people will think will one day take his title, the number four ranked player from Belarus, Vladimir Samsonov. Now, Samsonov took the first game of this confrontation. Remember, it's best of five by 21 points to 15. We're going to join it in the second game, and Samsonov's leading Kong by 17 points to 13.
Explosive shot. Great topspin to topspin rally there. And the forehand topspin back into Kong's backhand, the last place he expected it. Wonderful play.
18-14.
Delicate short play there. Samsonov just pushing the ball into the net, trying to keep it tight.
Not sure he was going to make it. Amazing defence from Samsonov. Not quite able to control the topspin that time.
This is where the question mark is. Has he got the big-time temperament?
That time, still good.
Interesting tactics there, variation in the serve, the backhand serve, had confidence in his backhand topspin. That's exactly what happened. He won the point with the backhand topspin. And now the umpire giving the yellow card to the Chinese coach, Chai Zhenhua. Not allowed to coach during the game. A wry grin.
Went for it, but did he go for it too early? They seem to think they know something. Massive point for the Belarusian. And here are two game points to go two love up. Up and those 5 points in a row in the middle of the game off Kong serve turned it around from 13-12 down to 17-13, and here's how he finished it.
well to get across there, and it won in the point.
And that's how he greeted it, and he's looking very close to making a major name for himself now against the world champion. He's two games up.
It's the final of the Pilkington Cup. Leicester.
They've got absolutely wild here.
Take on Saints.
They're on their way to Twickenham.
The Cheshire team have been on the ball all season, and victory in this game would be a sensation. But in Leicester, they face a team of proven cup pedigree, chasing a fifth Pilkington success. For both sides, though, defeat is not an option. Can Sale silence the Tigers' roar? The Pilkington Cup final next Saturday at 2, live on Sky Sports 1.
As a doctor, you need to know when to use patience and when to use speed. The V70 is all about composure. This environment is always testing your abilities. This car saves lives, and it helps me save lives.
Someone is playing a deadly game. Someone who's seen one too many scary movies.
Who are you?
The question is, where am I?
Critics say Scream is clever, hip, and scary.
This isn't a movie. This is life.
Scream, the new thriller from Wes Craven.
Meet Theramed. The bottle that's got it all. Toothpaste and mouthwash in one. Extra strong for cool, fresh breath. And tough enough to help in the fight against tooth decay. Theramed Liquid, two in one, more than just a toothpaste.
The new fragrance from Natural Plus works in harmony with your body to give you long-lasting natural freshness. New Iceni from Natural Plus.
Name three things that are difficult. Quantum physics, brain surgery, getting a loan. Actually, scrub that last one. Just ring Purple Loans on 0800 499 499. They don't want to know your life history. They don't want a reference from your boss. You don't even have to have a boss. As long as you own enough of your home to cover the loan. They don't care if you used to cheat at Conkers. But if you want to borrow between £5,000 and £100,000, call them up. They might say yes, they might say no. Either way, they'll give you a straight answer. Interested? Call Purple Loans free on 0800 499 499. Simple as that.
In a distant part of the galaxy...
Captain, I'm detecting another ship.
Something sinister...
Any life signs?
...lurks in space.
They seem to be trying to communicate with us, but we couldn't understand them.
Battle stations.
Back on Earth.
I think I heard something.
The chilling supernatural drama series.
Something's wrong. I felt it.
What did you do to her?
Star Trek Voyager at 8, followed by Poltergeist, The Legacy at 9. Monday on Sky One.
So, Kong Linghui, his title on the line now, the world champion. Is he going out here in the semi-final against this brilliant 21-year-old from Minsk in Belarus, Vladimir Samsonov? Love to. Wobbled in the past, Don. I just don't see it happening here.
I'm really impressed with Samsonov. As I said to you early, tactically, I had great problems advising anybody on how to play him. He just is so strong in every department. He seems to have so much time. And indeed, he's staying cool on the big points.
Three, one. surprised that Kong's going down that backhand side as much as he is. He's getting a little run here going, but I don't know quite why he's not switching it forehand. Well, that was an amazing get. But Kong punishing him once more, and he's done well there and opened up. Terrific reflex there. But Kong's 3 points in front. Read the return, spot on.
The third game can be psychologically a tough game. If you're 2-0 up, of course, the best of three in the team event, you've won.
Net service, 1-5.
Of course, in the singles event, best of five, you still need one more. And maybe at that unconscious level, Samsonov has just taken the pressure off a fraction. Kong now playing strong topspin from close to the table. And they're sending Samsonov the wrong way.
Net service, 1-7.
Well, on return, he is just incredible at the moment.
Superb return of serve there.
Threatens to be the worst day of his career, really. He's lost in the men's doubles, in the mixed doubles final with Deng Yaping, but could he turn this around? Two games down from losing his world singles title.
Rocket topspin there. Samsonov's not sure which way the ball was going. Good service. Kong is round. And initially there, Samsonov going the wrong way.
Net service. 9-3.
Again, the third ball attack does for Samsonov.
Samsonov there, sweat on his back, he's just wiping it away.
10-3.
Kong just making sure that it wasn't going on the table, but he really is electric right now.
Well, in fairness to Kong, he's played absolutely outstanding in the third game so far, and the response, I guess you would expect, of a world champion.
Samsonov gives him the fist as if to say, I'm coming back at you. Again, the switch does the trick. I'm surprised he's not doing that more down to the forehand.
I think both players have got to look to switch, Simon, to move the ball around, to get him first, to stay close to the table and play strong topspins.
And again, terrific angles and immense power.
Great forehand there. Good backhand down the line, then the forehand on the diagonal. Kong almost in position, almost returned it.
Net service, 13-7.
Devilish return. Remember at this stage in the second game that he won all 5 points off Kong's serve.
Two out of two so far.
And what a great forehand topspin down the line.
For those of you watching table tennis for the first time in England, this is the kind of excitement that world-class table tennis can produce.
Great recovery there by Samsonov, returning the ball off the top of the net. A brave serve there from Kong Linghui, the long pass and one into the backhand. Took Samsonov by surprise. Samsonov now, of course, with his five serves. Takes the first one.
He seems to have got Kong again. He's coming from a long way back. He left himself a lot to do in this third game. But just at the moment, he seems to have the mastery.
Brave play from Samsonov. He pushed it long and fast into Kong's backhand, took him by surprise. 3 out of 3 from this sequence of 5 serves.
13-16. You know the Chinese are worried when they applaud a mistake like that.
4!
Yeah, spot on. You can see right into the body. No way you could get the lever working there.
Absolutely right, straight into the body there, no chance. Good tactics from Samsonov.
So Kong serving now, 16-14. Powerhouse attack.
Samsonov always on the defensive here, always blocking. He knew he had to take the initiative, he took a gamble, ran round for that forehand topspin, just missed. Samsonov, of course, with his 5 serves at the end of this third game, so the next 2 points absolutely vital. Bad miss here by Kong Linghui. Wonderful return of serve there, the most delicate of shots, touched it back short over the net, as we see here, and then he's in with that forehand topspin down the line.
What a miss, and what a time. It could be very costly indeed, because Samsonov, at 17-18, if he gets 4 of these 5 serves, he's through to his first World Championship final.
Solid play there by Kong Linghui.
Yeah, it was always going to be Kong Linghui's rally, really. Samsonov plugged on the forehand. And that's the kind of rally he really likes. And he's got 3 game points now, Kong Linghui. Well played. The game of a world champion, Samsonov, pegging him back all the time. But he left himself too much to do.
Absolutely magnificent rally at the end there. Kong Linghui winning it with that forehand topspin.
Brave, brave man. And a phenomenal table tennis too. It's Samsonov still leading though, 2-1.
Bank holiday football on Sky Sports, and the top two sides in England and Scotland are on parade. It's Manchester United versus Middlesbrough in Ford Football Special. Alex Ferguson's team is sure to have a warm welcome in store for Brian Robson's beleaguered Borough side. Then from Scotland, it's Rangers versus Motherwell. Walter Smith's team have set the pace throughout an historic season and now face a Motherwell side fighting for survival. Great football action. Bank holiday Monday from 11, live on Sky Sports 1.
Want to see our totally new way to get permanent hair color? Breakthrough to new Hydrance, the first water-based permanent color cream from Clairol. Hydrance color cream technology is designed to be gentle to your hair while you color it. By using the power of water, Hydrance deeply saturates every strand with permanent moisture-rich color. Your hair has never felt so healthy, looks so beautiful. Breakthrough to new Hydrance from Clairol. First there was hair color, now there's Hydrance.
Life didn't get any better than this for the mud teenagers of Bongabon. Until one day, something orange rather than brown entered their lives. See, things are looking up already. Now things are really looking up. Hey, nice wife. Hey, nice drink.
Hey, nice skin.
You could say the mud teenagers' attitudes have changed somewhat. If posing was an Olympic sport, these guys would be gold medalists. Fanta, welcome to the world.
Lena, Mina, action, adventure from the Far East, gut-wrenching, bullet-riddled sagas, filled with violence, betrayal, grief. A season of explosive films and stars with inspirational epics from director John Woo. The ultimate in action. Made in Hong Kong. Sunday nights on Bravo.
Bums. Weirdos.
What does she want to go to New York for?
Well, this mum's ever been is New Malden.
She doesn't even like heights.
I think I'm really lost.
Is that it up there? I think it's up there.
Take the fifth decimal plus.
Of course, quite a stare down the club.
It's her money. She can do what she likes with it.
Good looking out, baby.
Oh, I feel better already.
Your city's turned me into a shopaholic.
I got the flavour.
I love New York. I'll give you I love New York.
Taxi!
Have a nice day now.
Whatever you've set your heart on, make sure you've got MasterCard in your corner.
Start by Conlon Huey there, very brave, backhand to backhand, switches it down the line. No spin on the service there from Samsonov. The float service misread by Kong, pushed it off the end of the table. If anything, I felt in that third game, Samsonov backed a little bit off the table. I'm sure he will seem determined to stay close to the table. Yeah, beautiful change of angle. I'd always fancy Kong, though, to win rallies like that. Even though it's spectacular stuff and Samsonov looks exceptional, still when he's away from the table and Kong's up to the table and Kong's the winner. But it was the net cord actually that forced Samsonov away then. Two each.
Two, three.
Net service. 2-3.
So quick, Kong. Wide to that forehand.
Samsonov unlucky as well. Just step round. Plays the backhand on the diagonal, steps round, goes for the forehand down the line.
Interesting, Samsonov going down the forehand side there. And try to fool him by reversing it that time, but no luck.
Net service.
Samsonov certainly making a determined effort to stay up to the table to make the first strong topspin, exactly what he does here. The long push into the backhand, close to the table, strong forehand topspin.
Kong's footwork just let him down. He was reaching for it a little too much.
Good chance to make that. Kong, slight bonus, I would say, for Samsonov. Can he now capitalise? So strong, Kong Ling Hu, with that forehand topspin when he's close to the table.
Still not totally reading the serve.
Net service, 7-5.
Again, another great rally. And it's Kong Ling Hui there with the backhand topspin that makes the winner.
Net service, 7-6.
Well, before it was the backhands from Samsonov which were holding sway. Now, Kong beginning to reply, drawing the error there out of Samsonov. It's 7-7.
Net service, 7-7.
Didn't like that at all. The Chinese bench and the supporters just behind them look a lot more energized now.
Great return of serve there from Samsonov. He made his mind up it was going to be a positive return. He steps round even though it's wide on the backhand and makes the winner on the diagonal.
Net service, 8-8.
Just missing with that backhand flick now.
Kong, of course, is staying that little bit closer, putting him under a bit more pressure. It really is an excellent match.
How did he miss it? It was there for him. Only, what, a centimetre away, I should think. Maybe two. But he shouldn't have missed it. He's normally as smooth as silk. He just launched himself a bit at that.
Strong backhand from Samsonov. Straight into Kong Ling Hui's backhand.
Fantastic shot. Samsonov may have read it, but there was nothing he could do about it. In fact, he didn't read it. So service changes, 2 points adrift.
Good short serve there from Samsonov. The second bounce was going to be over the table. Kong Ling Hui tried to get in the big topspin. The service not quite long enough to make that shot.
Struggling again to read the serve. Pops it up. Bang.
Great service there from Samsonov. Invited Conlon Hui again to make the backhand topspin and then came in with the counter topspin and then dominated the rally to win the point.
Three out of three.
Net service, 12-11. Net service, 12-11.
Forehand. A good short service again. Forces Kong to push over the table. And then he's in with that forehand down the line.
It's funny, the backhand may be slightly less than it was, the forehand's more than it was. And he's 2 points up. Struggling on serve. 5 points out of five for Samsonov there.
Interesting then to see Kong look to the bench quite clearly, getting very worried. Just a fraction too far away from the table to make that backhand.
Can touch the atmosphere right now. Oh, well, he's set himself up. You can see the mouth gaping open. What a chance after retrieving on the backhand. Well, he left himself open there, Kong, and Samsonov says thanks a lot.
Great touch first by Samsonov, and then a great shot over the table.
Oh, yes! That may be the clincher. They think so. Against serve, Samsonov now has serve. And this point has given him a four-point advantage.
What a magnificent backhand block down the line there from Samsonov. And there's the reaction.
17-13, Kong is just 4 points away from losing his title. How do you beat this? Fantastic entertainment.
How on earth Kong got back in this rally, I'll never know. And he plays the backhand, the chop block there, two times. And then Samsonov overhits.
Most of the neutrals are smiling, the committed are frowning. It's too tense for them, but everybody else thoroughly enjoying it. Oh, yes. Didn't he read that serve?
Went slightly long there, though, the short serve. Second bounce, quite a bit over the white line, the baseline. Better service, but an excellent return from Conlon Hui. He kept the return tight. Samsonov only made a half a topspin. Conlon Hui quickly in.
It's a one-point game. Edges closer, 3 points away.
from Samsonov. The second bounce would have been on the baseline. Conlin, who he wasn't sure whether to play over the table or play the long top spin, hesitated, made the error.
And he still jogs up and down, just gliding around the table. 2 points away, 16-19. Just went for it all, Kong. Here are four match points, this for a place in the final. Samsonov makes him wait.
17-20.
Great flick there by Kong Lin Hui.
Match point number two.
Yes! The biggest win of his life. Samsonov is through to the final. Incredible talent. And now the question marks are very nearly all gone. To beat the world champion in a match like this in the semi-final, well, he's answered the few critics that he has, and he's got to do it one more time. Here's the moment. He, remember, squandered one match point. Here was the second. Vladimir Samsonov beats Kong. Kong has lost his title. And here, the prince of table tennis, who very shortly may be the king himself.
And so the defending champion, Kong Lin Hui, goes out of the men's competition. He won't be able to defend the title that he won 2 years ago. And with that, of course, goes China's hopes of completing the clean sweep of all seven titles, which they won last time around. Colin Wilson, we said before that this chap from Belarus, Vladimir Samsonov, was one of the great rising stars of the game, and he's proved everybody right there, hasn't he?
That's right. He's a young man, but he's been rising fast. He was quarter-finalist in the Olympics in 1996. Then he was European Masters champion last September. He's now ranked four in the world. Kong Lin Hui knew he was a threat, and too much of a threat on the evening.
He is such an agile player, and yet he's so tall. How does he combine that agility with such height?
I think Samsonov's real skill is his timing. His strokes look slow, but when you watch the ball come off the bat, the ball is going so fast. I think he has the best timing and the most efficiency of stroke of any player in the world.
Now, he has this extraordinary high serve that he uses, which we can have a look at. He throws it up for miles.
That's right. He throws the ball up very high. This is something that the Chinese introduced 20 years ago. Throws the ball up very high, using the forehand, but interestingly enough, makes no attempt to hide the ball behind his body or behind the free arm. So the other player can see clearly what's going on, but even then, his deception and his disguise and his variation are so strong that Kong Lin Hui was having big trouble with Samsonov's serve.
And we also saw him vary that serve a lot, didn't
he?
Yes, he used the backhand serve sometimes, then the shorter throw.
That's right. He was clearly changing it all the time, going back to that staple diet of the high serve just to keep Kong Lin Hui guessing, keep him on edge.
Now, Kong Lin Hui, well, he started to get back in the game and he was very much playing to Samsonov's backhand.
Yes, as we saw during that game, what happened is that Kong Lin Hui was playing very wide to Samsonov's backhand. You can see him have to play two shots there, but Kong Lin Hui running around his own backhand to get his forehand in wide of Samsonov's backhand.
Now, of course, he goes on now to face Jan Ove Voldner of Sweden in the final, an all-European final. That is going to be a classic men's final, surely.
It's going to be unbelievable. Samsonov's only 20 years old. He's been training 10 years for this one match. This is his chance to become world champion. They played in the team event and Samsonov won, but my prediction from before, Jan Ove Voldner.
Really? You're going to stick with the Swede?
The Swede, I think, will win tomorrow.
Okay, well, we shall see, because if you join us tomorrow, you will find out who wins that men's title and, of course, who will win the women's title as well. I hope you can join us for a bank holiday feast of table tennis. Join us on Sky Sports 3 at 7 p.m. tomorrow. We'll see you then. Bye-bye. We'll be right back. the jewel in the crown of women's table tennis. She's dominated the sport for the past decade, and today she defends her world singles title for the second consecutive year. Deng first picked up a bat at the age of five. By sweet 16, she'd won the first of her seven world titles. Today, she aims to add another string to that long, long bow. In the men's singles, the old champion has gone. Could we see a new king installed? Vladimir Samsonov has grown in stature with every game he's played in these world championships. His defeat of Kong Linghui in the semi-finals surprised few who've seen him mature over the past year. But if a new champion is born, another former title holder will have to bow out. Jan-Ove Voldner won the world title back in 1989. 8 years on, and he's got the taste for battle once again. Hello, it's finals day at the 44th World Table Tennis Championships at the GMEX Centre in Manchester. A little later in the programme, we'll be bringing you news of how the three doubles finals finished. But first of all, we're going to concentrate on the singles events. And first to the women's final, where really, I suppose, you wouldn't bet against the world champion and reigning champion, of course, Deng Yaping. She faces Wang Nan for a chance to lift the trophy once again. And as you can see, Deng has waylaid pretty much the rest of the Chinese team on her way to this final, including the young pretender Li Zhu, but she hasn't yet come up against her teammate Wang Nan, who's made it an all-Chinese affair once again by coming safely through the bottom half of the draw. Well, my guest, as ever, is Colin Wilson, former England player, and we've talked all about how wonderful Deng Yaping has been through this tournament so far, Colin, but has Wang Nan got the game to beat her today?
I think technically she has, and she is a threat. She's number nine in the world, and she's also beaten many of the Chinese players, but I think Deng has slightly the psychological advantage here.
OK, thanks very much, Colin. So can Deng Yaping add the women's singles title to the women's team title she has already won in Manchester? Remember, it's the best of five games. Your commentators for this are Wang Don and Don Parker.
Wang Nan takes the first point in the final. And therefore leads one love in the first game. Deng Yaping round on the backhand side, playing a forehand cross court. Overhit. And so it's a good start for Wang Nan.
Of course, it's very easy for Deng Yaping to wrap up completely and convincingly to retain her title. And for her opponent, Wang Nan, it's the very first time she has gone that far to the finals of the World Table Tennis Championships. I'm sure she must be a little bit nervous here.
Unlucky there, Wang Nan, she was going for the long, fast serve down the backhand. Good variation, it just caught the top of the net, flicked off the end. Deng now with her serves to come.
Net. 2-3.
Let service.
Three all.
Wang Nan, the long fast push wide to the forehand, as we see here. But Deng Yaping very quickly across, smash into Wang Nan's backhand.
Four, three.
Again, it's interesting to note Deng Yaping uses what we call a combination bat two different types of surfaces. As you can see, the black side there, the smooth side, very good for gripping the ball, generating spin. But on the backhand side, on the red side, she has what we call a long pimple surface. Sends through a completely different spin. Makes life very awkward for the opponent.
She's one of the few Chinese players, especially among the women players, who actually has the long pimples on one side.
Excellent play from the young Chinese player, Wang Nan. Good backhand on the diagonal.
Wang Nan defeated Una in the semi-finals to come this far. She certainly doesn't want to lose to Deng Yaping very easily.
6-5.
Deng trying to step around the backhand, not quite in position, and makes the error. That was an excellent topspin from Wang Nan. Wide to Deng Yaping's forehand. She steps round, the good topspin here, wide down the forehand. Deng Yaping only able to get the edge of the bat to the ball.
In a previous record, Deng Yaping definitely almost won all the matches against Wang Nan here. It's a great test for Wang Nan in the World Table Tennis Championships here.
What's interesting is that Wang Nan is having little problems when Deng Yaping punches the ball with the pimples. And that's a particular shot that's caused all her opponents problems so far, but maybe the fact they practice together will actually be in favour of Wang Nan. We'll have to wait and see.
Well, definitely she's very familiar with Deng Yaping's style. As you said, they played together and they live in the same dormitory, trained together, virtually like sisters.
Wang Nan's topspin catching the top of the net. Sufficient to win the point. And so an excellent start in this first game for Wang Nan. She now leads by 3 points. And again,
6-10.
Fortune favours the brave. She was going for the long, fast push to the forehand. A very positive return of serve. Good to see.
It's a good start for Wang Nan up to this point, leading 4 points, or 5 points now.
Deng Yaping spun the ball up. A packed audience here at GMEX. Very fortunate there, Deng Yaping. The service caught the edge of the table on her side.
I think Deng Yaping is going to rewrite history if she wins here again. Three times of world championship. Just incredible in modern history in women's singles.
The top of the net, flicking the ball off the end of the table. Wang Nan leads 12-8 in the first game. Just mistimed the backhand. Deng Yaping threw it up a bit higher, forced the error. Excellent play by Wang Nan there. A couple of excellent blocks by Deng Yaping. She really punched it with the pimple surface of her racket, but caused Wang Nan no problems at all. Excellent play, good forehand topspin. Deng blocks off the end of the table. Oh, magic play there.
I think Wang Nan gets very excited now playing in the finals against her sister Deng Yaping. Or teammate as well. Beautiful forehand right down the line.
Again, Wang Nan spinning the ball up with the backhand. Deng smashing off the end of the table. The spin from the backhand, the smash off the end. Excellent backhand hit.
9-16,
playing with extreme confidence, Wang Nan. The pushed return from Deng slightly high, but what an excellent backhand out wide to Deng's forehand. Again, she was assisted by the net, Wang Nan, but nevertheless, excellent play. She was always looking to be positive. As soon as she had the opportunity, she was in with the top spins. Just caught the top of the net, but nevertheless, point to Wang Nan.
Wang Nan really defended herself very nicely. And so far, she has been covering her ground fully.
Deng Yaping moving the ball around there. She pushes wide to the forehand. And it's the block wide to the forehand that wins the point.
It's just that you never count Deng Yaping out until the last minute or last second. She's such a tenacious fighter.
11-18.
Again, excellent tactics from Wang Nan. She spun the ball up in the air. The service slightly long, up the back of the ball, a lot of topspin. Deng Yaping blocks off the end of the table.
I think she does make a lot of mistakes up to this point. Deng Yaping's accuracy is not as impressive as we saw in the previous games.
And now we have 9 game points in the first game. Big surprise. Good backhand down the line from Deng Yaping.
I'm sure Deng Yaping will bounce back very strongly in the second game if she loses the first one.
Still 8 game points. And there it is. First game to Wang Nan, 21-12. Excellent performance by the young Chinese player. And she'll be delighted with that start. The service. And she's straight in with that forehand. Powerful forehand topspin. Very consistent. Deng Yaping punching the ball back every time. But great topspins from Wang Nan. And so, somewhat of a surprise here at the GMEX. The first game to Wang Nan, 21-12.
On a higher level, I wish it were me. Winning the race for the line, forcing through the pack, making the crowd gasp. But it's not me. I don't have their speed, their power, their brilliance. I can't do it, but I can live it every weekend.
Super League, the live match experience, Friday and Sunday on Sky Sports 1.
You're tuned to Ray on Reef Radio.
Wishing farewell to my good buddy Franco, who's been lured away to the big city for a
measly 100% pay raise.
So it's
goodbye to sleepy old Reef Harbor. No more days at the races. No more nights on the town. You're gonna miss popping out for seafood.
And I
know you'll miss the way they serve Bacardi around here. But if you gotta go.
We
like to be selling summer and sun in this advertisement? Heat waves and vacation. Travel, blue seas and long beaches.
I wanna wake up with you.
And parties that never end. What we are selling are four CDs with 60 songs that you can dance to for more than 4 hours. What you gonna do when they come for you? Good Thing Going is a definitive reggae collection on four CDs from TV Shop. Call TV Shop on the number shown now. Order this year's Sunniest Collection and let the party begin.
Now a new surprise from Viennetta. Soft ice cream and crunchy biscuit. Biscuit sensation Viennetta. New from Wool's.
Life didn't get any better than this for the mud teenagers of Bungabon. Until one day, something orange rather than brown entered their lives. See, things are looking up already. Now things are really looking up. Hey, nice wife. Hey, nice drink.
Hey, nice skin.
You could say the mud teenagers' attitudes have changed somewhat. If posing was an Olympic sport, these guys would be gold medalists. Fanta, welcome to the world.
Quick play from both players, but it was the speed of Deng Yaping that eventually won the rally. Backhand down the line, and again, the backhand down the line to win the point.
Yes, even the impartial Chinese audience here applauded for that. It's just unbelievable rally.
What impressed me in the first game, Wang Nan was so consistent with the top spins, the combination bat, the two different surfaces used by Deng Yaping, causing her very few problems. Rallies at the beginning of this second game. The smash, the backhand lob, and the second smash from Deng Yaping. Wu Nan just missing the edge of the table.
3-1.
Yes, indeed, she bounces back so strongly. She wants to take the initiative, starting her own attack soon. A bit concerned from Wang Nan's face now.
Home.
Good start for Deng.
Well, this match certainly has drawn a lot of audience.
Two, four.
Great smash from Wang Nan. That's a good service. Deng Yaping misreading the spin and the smash hitting Deng Yaping on the hand.
Beautifully planned by Deng Yaping, send the ball long to the far corner and then just with a sudden change of direction and acceleration of power, and she nailed it.
Again, clever play from Wang Nan. She's just taking the pace out of the ball, throwing it up deep into the backhand on that occasion. And Deng Yaping blocking off the end of the table, just caught the top of the net. What an excellent
the diagonal there, wide to Deng Yaping's forehand.
Both players have quality topspin. On the other hand, both players are fast attacking players. So you can see that speed is everything here for them. So far, it seems to me that Wang Nan has really been very impressive.
Well played, Deng Yaping. Good forehand topspin.
When she has her gestures like that, you cannot imagine that she actually got foot injury and also back pain. It's just incredible. She's such a top-class fighter.
Good backspin serve there from Deng. Yaping punching very hard with the backhand, using the long pimple surface to great effect. Punching the ball around the table, down the line there, wins the point.
Indeed, you just cannot fight too much weak point from Deng Yaping's side. And his strategy is so well connected.
Wang Nan has to be careful how high she throws the ball up. On this occasion, she just threw it a little bit too high, not that much topspin, and the smash from Deng Yaping. Slightly Deng fortunate there, Deng Yaping. A capacity crowd here, G-Mex, enjoying an excellent final between, on the right, Deng Yaping, and the left, Wang Nan.
Even though they are teammates, I think the audience, and plus their teammates, do want to see a real seesaw battle here.
That's wonderful play from Deng Yaping. She's really getting into the groove now. That forehand smash, hardly missing at all. Great shot.
Yes, she just covered herself so nicely with her both swings.
4-13.
And this is just the sort of reply that Deng Yaping would have liked after losing the first game, 21-12. She now has a 9-point advantage.
And her teammate, Wang Nan, is a little bit discouraged.
Things not quite working there for Wang Nan. The backhand on the diagonal just caught the top of the net, flicked it off the end of the table.
Once Deng is completely informed, her opponent tends to fade a little bit.
5-14.
Deng Yaping nods. She knows it's the right thing to do, the long push to the forehand. She knows she has to be positive on the returner serve. That's exactly what she's doing. Well retrieved there by Wang Nan. Spun the ball up. Deng making the mistake on the backhand side. Up it goes. Deng mistiming that backhand down the line.
Yeah, certainly well intended to try to hit the right hand side, the backhand side of Wang Nan.
14-6.
Assisted by the net, but Wang Nan winning a few points and with a few more, we'll be back in this second game.
Deng Yaping is about 24 years old, originally from Henan province. Actually, she joined the national team very late because of her height. initially she was not chosen for the national team at all, but she showed that she does have her ability to beat anyone in the world.
Great angle from Deng Yaping across the table. Of course, with a left-hander playing a right-hander, when you play on the diagonal, it's forehand into backhand.
Deng Yaping's achievement is just incredible. In 1992 Barcelona, she took 2 gold medals, and last year she repeated this history. Just incredible.
Wang Yan overhitting there.
And frustration can be obviously seen here.
Great backhand, very relaxed. But then again, 7-19. I think even she's accepted that this one is beyond her reach. But important to try and get back into some sort of rhythm, get her shots going for the third game. And so Deng Yaping with 12 game points. There it is, the second game, and Deng Yaping wins 21-8 and levels it at 1 game all. Confirmation there, Wang Nan the first game 21-12, Deng Yaping the second game 21-8. Yaping there with the push return, punching with the backhand. The long pimples used to great effect. And she's back in the match at 1-1, and there she is, composing herself once again.
Well, during the first break, she certainly regrouped herself very successfully. And in the second game, she just trounced her opponent 21-8. Unbelievable.
Interesting that the Chinese team choosing the individual event when 2 Chinese players play each other to have no coaches there. It's a change in policy from years ago, but the girls, or the ladies I should say, working their own tactics out.
1-2-3, love all.
I think a lot of the improvisation and also the performance on court mean a lot here. Basically, they just can tell themselves to calm down and regroup.
Good backhand there from Deng down the middle of the table. Wang Nan not sure where to play the backhand or the forehand there.
In addition to playing ping pong, which is her major career, Deng Yaping studies now in Tsinghua University in Beijing, China, majoring in English. So she does speak English now.
Over 3.
Deng Yaping now, very solid, no unforced errors. She coped well there with the variation in speed and spin. Has taken the first 3 points in this third game. Great shot, Wang Nan. She actually faded the ball there. She came across the inside to put side to middle.
This 19-year-old girl finished the 3rd in the Chinese National Championships. last year, she really performed pretty well. But of course, by comparison, Deng Yaping won her first world title at the age of 18. I'm afraid so far her record cannot be chased by a lot of competitors so easily.
Good topspin there. Oh, Wang Nan spinning the ball up in the air, forcing Deng to block off the end of the table. Rushing up the back of the ball, imparting extra topspin. Very good return of service there from Deng. Push the ball wide to Wang's forehand. Wang just not quite quick enough to get in position, and the ball caught the top edge of her bat.
She's trying her best, certainly. And she knows that this third game is so important here. Her backspin, her backhand topspin has got a problem now. Accuracy, seems to me, is vanishing.
Again, it's interesting that now Deng is using her racket to maximum effect. Wang's backhand missing a few recently, but it's the extra pressure that Deng's putting her under with the long pimple surface on the backhand side. The ball comes through at a different pace than off the reverse side. And again, the variation of pace. And having lost the first game, Deng has been in total control during the second and so far in the third, and now leads 11-4, 12-4 in the third game. Moving the ball around, then drilling it into Wang's backhand, into the forehand, and then pins her down the backhand side, keeps her in the backhand, and wins the point.
She's just so quick, and nobody really can compete with her at this stage. And she covers herself so nicely.
14-4.
Good topspin down the line from Deng. I think the ball caught the top of the net, but nevertheless, a great shot. Just caught the top of the net. That was a great smash by Wang. She came right round on the backhand side, created the room, and played a great forehand. Wide to the backhand, then the smash down the line.
Nicely placed.
Slower ball from Wang Nan.
14-1.
Deng over anxious there.
I guess some of the audience actually are cheering Wang Nan up instead. Because after all, you tend to be sympathetic on the weaker side.
7-14.
Again, the slow topspin wins the point, but Deng's asking, did it touch? And no hesitation there from Wang Nan. The nod of the head.
15.
It did touch, the umpires didn't see it. Deng saw it, and Wang Nan acknowledged that.
That's right, she was raising a question to the umpire. Did it touch the edge? And they admitted.
Again, the variation there from Deng, the black side, the reverse rubber, the ball comes off quicker. And then off the red side, the long pimple surface, the different speed wins the point. And now Deng with a 10-point lead in this third game.
She just keeps pressuring her opponent, Wang Nan, here. And Wang Nan definitely feels that.
Great play there from Wang Nan. She moved Deng Yaping around the table, got the ball up in the air, and then an excellent smash across the table to win the point.
Yeah, I guess that winner really is a relief for Wang Nan. After all, she got one point like that.
88. Good variation on the service, the long fast serve down the line. Took Wang by surprise.
Was jammed, but she succeeded in returning the ball so successfully. That's well placed.
Very good top spin. Deep into Deng's backhand. Wins Wang Nan the point.
It's going to be tremendously difficult for Wang Nan to actually patch up the differences now.
19. Unlucky there, Wang Nan. I always like to see a positive return. She was going for the flick wide to Deng's forehand, just didn't quite work. Great smash. No topspin. Deng blocked the ball in the net.
Wang Nan's chance to narrow the gap now.
No mistake with Deng Yaping's smash, so it's 9 game points for a 2-1 lead. And there it is. Third game to Deng Yaping, 21-11. And she now leads by 2-1. Confirmation. Deng Yaping wins the third game 21-11 and leads by 2-1.
Super Sunday's definitive guide to men. Homer Simpson, super slob. Gary Hobson.
Everybody get down!
Super stressed. Superman, super cool.
What a show off.
Fox Mulder, supernatural.
The man we're looking for has a knack for vanishing in plain sight.
And Frank Black, super sleuth.
We're going to need another examination of the body.
5 super reasons for watching Sky One's Super Sunday.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived.
But what about him upstairs?
It's okay. He won't be up for hours.
Dad! Mom!
Don't worry. I'll go and get him.
Peugeot, the drive of your life.
Chappie, with its fish, white meat and cereals, has everything to keep a dog really healthy.
Oh.
Chappie, your keys.
I don't think so.
Have you seen my umbrella, Chappie? Oh, well, maybe later.
We have the soil. We have the vines. We make great wine.
Great wine.
So, what do people drink?
Wine.
1664.
Kronenbourg 1664, the best-loved premium beer in France.
The only ones drinking Chateau Châtelet.
Oh.
Are me and him. Me, anyway.
If you can't beat them, join up.
Join them.
Join them up. Join up. Then.
The new fragrance from Natural Plus works in harmony with your body to give you long-lasting natural freshness. New Iceni from Natural Plus.
A soft drink is not a magic potion, a status symbol, or a badge that says who I am. It will not make me popular.
Wanna hang?
It will not make me run faster or jump higher. It will not make me more attractive to the opposite sex, though I wish it would. If I need a badge, I'll become a security guard.
Welcome to the force,
if I need a refreshing drink, I'll obey my thirst. Image is nothing, thirst is everything. Sprite.
Okay, thank you, sir. Love all.
Of course, if you talk about physical condition, Wang Nan is in a better shape, because Deng Yaping has a lot of injury now. But she's a fighter, as we mentioned before. She's not going to give up. She's going to win this tournament. This is going to be her second gold medal in this championships.
Good backhand topspin from Wang Nan, the long fast serve. She reacted very quickly, spun it, used the wrist, brushed up the back of the ball. Deng Yaping blocks off the end of the table. Topspin service, the flick off the end of the table.
She's constantly cheering herself up.
Two, one.
What a great angle there by Deng Yaping. The backhand punched wide to Wang's forehand.
And just so well anticipated. The angle gets wider and wider.
Again, Deng Yaping assisted by the net. Sufficient to put off Wang Nan. Clever play there from Deng Yaping. She played to the middle of the table, knowing Wang Nan would go for the angle. Of course, from the middle, the angle isn't as acute, wide to the forehand. And Wang Nan blocked off the side of the table.
One, six.
I guess Wang Nan sensed that probably she can only move up three positions more than what she did 2 years ago in Tianjin.
And Deng Yaping stamps her authority immediately on this fourth game and opens up a 6-point lead.
Look at the way she is staring at her opponents. Really a fighter.
1-8.
The long push to the forehand. And then the slower ball to the middle of the table. Wang missed times.
It's just that nothing is working in favor of Wang Nan now.
Nine,
a comparatively simple topspin there for Wang Nan. She did well. She forced Deng to use the chop, the backspin, and then missed the forehand.
Nine,
there by both players. Deng Yaping running all around the table there, did extremely well to retrieve some of these shots. The drop shot from Wang brings her in. And then it's Wang's topspin forcing Deng to block off the end of the table.
Yeah, she got back to her position to regroup, but just that backhand set the ball too long.
Amazing use there of that long pimpled surface. She came sideways across the ball. We see here the technique across the ball, a lot of backspin on that ball, and into the net it goes. Wang Nan slightly fortunate, the backhand topspin just catching the edge of the table. There's the topspin, there's the edge.
Deng Yaping has got one more serve.
Oh, 11, one.
Wang stepping around the backhand to play the forehand. Unfortunately for her, it went off the end of the table. So Deng Yaping now leading 2-1 and by 11 points to 4 in this fourth game. It's the best of 5.
Otero.
And at the moment, it looks as though Deng is running away with this fourth game.
Wang Nan is so upset with herself. The backhand is just not working.
Oh, 13.
Excellent serve there from Wang Nan, the fast serve down the line.
I think Wang Nan does need audience to cheer her up a little bit. Otherwise, she's going to lose quickly here.
13-7.
Deng smash caught the top of the net. In she comes, top of the net, and off the end.
Deng's long pimpled bat really helped her to control the situation.
Again, clever play from Deng. She's just playing into the middle. She's not playing onto the bat of Wang. A Deng supporter. Control on the backhand side there from Deng. She was away from the table. She was able to do a sort of a chop block. It's not really a backspin shot. It's not really a block, somewhere in between the two. And then she comes in with the backhand hit and wins the point.
And Wang Nan is losing her confidence. Deng Yaping is just so great here. From a typical defensive position back to the attacking position so quickly and smoothly.
16-7.
Deng now with a 10-point lead and well on her way to this fourth game and the women's singles title.
Nothing is working for Wang Nan here. Once again, her backhand sandboard too long.
And here's the prize that goes to the winner. And that, at this point in time, is certainly looking like Deng Yaping.
Of course, it's going to be her third time to win this title. Deng Yaping won this title early in 1991. And 2 years ago in Tianjin, she recaptured this honor.
Great smash by Deng. Wang spun the ball up in the air, but an excellent smash. She's now 2 points away from the title. She now has 11 match points, leading 29.
Also the championship point.
But what an excellent backhand from Wang Nan.
I guess when you have no pressure at all, you can just smash it home like that so easily.
And so Deng has 10 match points for the women's singles title. And there it is. Deng Yaping is the world champion once again, with a convincing victory, winning that fourth game, 21-10. A delighted Deng Yaping waved to the crowd. The crowd acknowledged the fight that they've seen. One of the finest female players ever in the sport of table tennis.
I'm afraid in his short future, no one is going to ever near this record.
But it was a good performance by the young Wang Nan. But there she is, the 1997 world champion. And there it is, that final point. And a grin of delight there. Confirmation that Deng Yaping is the women's singles champion of the world, winning 3-1.
A short while ago, the greatest women player in the modern game was honoured as champion for the second year running. Wang Nan takes the silver and Wu Na collected the bronzes on behalf of herself and Li Ju.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the national anthem of China?
So Deng Yaping takes the applause of the crowd at the GMEX Centre in Manchester. She's won the world singles title for the third time in the last 4 world championships. And Colin Wilson, that is a tremendous record. She is just so dominant in this game. We say it over and over again. But what makes her so special?
I think what makes her so special is you can see the great thing that she has is an amazing fighting spirit. Quite often in that game, technically, she was no better than Wang Nan. Wang Nan has a very good technique, but she's just fighting and fighting. We've heard that she's injured, but it wasn't going to faze her, and she has possibly the best attitude that I've seen in any player in the last decade.
It did take her a while to settle down, though, in that first game, didn't it?
That's right. Wang Nan took the first game, and there were some very good rallies. They obviously know each other's game very well, and being a left-hander against a right-hander, Wang Nan was able to take advantage wide down Deng Yaping's forehand sometimes.
That's right, they were very much exploiting each other's forehand, weren't they?
That's right. We can see here a point where, in fact, Deng Yaping is going wide to Wang Nan's forehand once, twice, three times, but Wang Nan able to get wide of the forehand. She knows it's coming, and she's able to pressurise Deng Yaping into her backhand side.
One left-handed player, Wang Nan, one right-handed player, Deng Yaping. How did that affect the game between the two?
Well, it means that there is no backhand-to-backhand diagonal. When they play backhand-to-backhand, it's down the line, and that means that both players can be exploited if you get the ball very, very wide to the opponent's forehand.
Now, for Deng, she's been coming into this competition. She had a couple of buys. She had a buy and a walkover, I think, at the start of her singles, the defence of her title. Do you think that gave her a little bit of an edge towards the end of the competition?
Well, it certainly helps after playing a hard team event, and China won the gold in the team event, and Wang Nan not playing all the time in the team event. It definitely helped Deng Yaping to have a day or two's rest to get herself up again for the singles matches.
And of course, these two players, we heard in the commentary, they know each other so well. It must be quite difficult playing somebody who you've roomed with for the last few years.
I know, they've spent time in the same dormitory together. So they're at the National Academy in China. They must know each other's games inside out. But I think that gives Deng the psychological edge.
Well, she knew, didn't she, to force Wang Nan away from the table at times. And that's where she really got into control.
That's right. If we see here, Deng Yaping staying close to the table, just getting Wang Nan away from the table enough that she's just hitting there, but hitting on the defensive, and in the end making an error on her backhand, which Dong pointed out she was making more and more as the match went on.
Now, we saw in the game, Deng Yaping is using what we know now is the combination bat. Wang Nan was using similar surfaces on her bat. What difference must that have made during that match?
Well, Wang Nan is using the same rubber on both sides of her bat, very fast and very spinny, but Deng Yaping has, of course, the long pimples on the backhand, which we've mentioned, and that means that the ball comes off very much slower, and when Wang Nan topspins, the ball comes back with chop. So we can see here Deng Yaping able to use her backhand under pressure there. It's a bit higher, but the change of pace is so great, the ball comes over much slower to Wang Nan. Again, another backhand error from Wang Nan.
Now, we heard that Deng Yaping, there's talk of whether she's going to retire or not, but presumably now she's won her world title again. Will she have a taste for another few titles before she finally packs it in?
I think when you win, you want to go and win again, especially when you have the kind of fighting attitude that Deng Yaping has. I very much hope that Deng Yaping will overcome any injury problems that she has and plays again and again.
Well, I hope she does too, and I'm sure you do at home. She is a wonderful player to watch. So, will the men's final be quite so straightforward? Remember, this one is an all-European affair. We're going to see the action very shortly. This is how the players made it to the final. Vladimir Samsonov has already conquered the reigning champion Kong Linghui, who'd looked vulnerable early on in the draw. 3-1 saw the 20-year-old from Belarus make his first world final, and he faces the 89 champion and world number 2 Jan-Ove Voldner, who put out one of the favourite Jean-Philippe Gatien of France and then Yan Sen to book his place. So it really is a final with a lot of intrigue to it. Two Europeans in action, and Colin Wilson, I know all the way through you've been saying Jan-Ove Voldner for the title. Are you going to change your mind at all?
No, I'm not going to change my mind. I'm going to stick with him.
He's been in action, though, before this men's singles final, in a semi-finals and a final of the doubles, the men's doubles. Incidentally, we'll see that game a little later on. That must affect him, surely, coming into this game.
Yes, playing two or three best-of-five matches in one day can be very tiring. Voldner has worked very hard on his fitness. In the past, he hasn't always been the fittest player, but he's been working on it. It is a danger that he's been playing the same day for quite a lot, and that will work to Samsonov's advantage.
And what about Samsonov? I mean, he is a fast rising star in this game, isn't he?
That's right, he's a fantastic player, 20 years old. He's come seemingly from nowhere, but we know how hard he's been trying behind the scenes back in Belarus and around the world to improve his game.
Okay, well, let's go to the men's final. It's best of five games, remember. Your commentators are Don Parker and, first of all, Simon Reid.
Here we go then. Final of the men's singles in the World Championship. Vladimir Samsonov on the left from Belarus. Jan-Ove Voldner, the former champion.
First game,
the world number 2.
Samsonov to serve.
shot from Waldner.
Service slightly long, Waldner very quickly round. Great forehand.
One of the moments of the fortnight for me was the way that Waldner started in his quarter-final against Jean-Philippe Gatien. He was razor-sharp, and he beat Gatien 21-7 in that opening game. I've never seen table tennis quite like it.
There's no doubt that when Waldner is razor-sharp, then arguably there's no one in the world to touch him.
Samsonov, a quarter-final, quarter-finalist in the Olympics in Atlanta. Still to crack it in the World Championships. Waldner determined that he won't this evening.
Comes around the outside of the ball here, puts the side spin on to take it wide.
And the big forehand does the trick. Waldner's forehand is like gold so far.
It's so interesting to watch the point of contact between Waldner's bat and the ball. Always stroking different parts of the ball, imparting different spin, particularly side spin. That time straight through it, the rocket top spin into the body.
So it's been four out of four forehands behind the serve from Waldner that won the points. Oh, but not that time. Amazing reactions from Samsonov.
Read that one perfectly, and the block across the table.
Four, seven.
Quite interesting, when Samsonov serves, he doesn't actually try to shield the ball with the free arm. So many of the top players use the free arm, so the opponent can't see the ball. Samsonov there drops his free arm out of the way.
Five,
but nevertheless,
seven.
Still has that fast accelerating wrist that brushes the ball to impart the spin.
5-8.
So relaxed. Even when shots are blasted at him, he seems to have time. Was that?
Invited the top spin with the push return and then sends it back almost as fast into Samsonov's body.
Ten, six.
Consistent top spins that time from Waldner.
12-6.
He's having to fight Samsonov at the moment to stay with him. Waldner threatening to take flight.
Impossible to tell where Waldner is going to place the ball. The short serve, the push from Samsonov, and then where is this ball going? And there it goes, wide to the backhand.
Well played, Samsonov.
7-13, Samsonov.
Great control from Samsonov there. Top's been kicking off the table.
Interesting, a lot of people who I spoke to before this match started, and a lot of them, Waldner fans, thought that Samsonov would beat him this time, but Waldner looks to be again at his very best. He's reading it like a book. Jürgen Pearson watches on. His expression never changes either.
The high toss serve, slightly long.
8-15.
This was the day when many thought the command might change and the younger breed would take centre stage.
9:15.
Forehand.
Testing time now for Samsonov. He has to make positive returns of these next five serves. And there he pushed the ball back. It enabled Bollner to get in with a topspin. And Bollner wins it with that first topspin.
Oh, too good. Working around in the game. The forehand has been the shot of the game so far.
17-11.
Any other player here would have gone down the diagonal, not Voldner, straight down the line.
6 points to the good.
Heavy backspin on the push there from Samsonov, deep into Volner's backhand. Good return.
Again, right into the body. Another cracking forehand from Volner. His third ball attack has been invincible.
Well, 19.
2 points away from the first game. Oh, yes.
What can you say? Absolutely remarkable. Great topspin from Samsonov. Nonchalantly cross-court from Voldner.
Game points. And a really brilliant end to the game from Jan Ove Voldner. Carrying on the immense form he's shown at the age of 31. Remember, it's 8 years since he won the world title at the age of 23. And now it looks here in Manchester as if he might be able to carry the form through one more time and win it again. Still a long way to go against a brilliantly talented opponent, but Voldner takes the opening game 21-12.
It's the final of the Pilkington Cup. Leicester.
They've got absolutely wild here.
Take on Saints.
They're on their way to Twickenham.
The Cheshire team have been on the ball all season, and victory in this game would be a sensation. But in Leicester, they face a team of proven cup pedigree, chasing a fifth Pilkington success. For both sides, though, defeat is not an option. Can Sale silence the Tigers' roar? The Pilkington Cup final, Saturday at 2, live on Sky Sports 1.
Admiring the fingertip controls of my Vectra CD player when...
Take me to the old chemical works.
My clock, he's packing a piece, so I don't argue.
I turn on my Vectra's new navigational gizmo, the Corin.
Turn right.
It says. My ABS cuts in when I see some cops.
And while he eats carpet, I change the route. This is a shortcut, I tell him. But not to where he wants to go.
Just feel the softness. New Formula Organics Root Nourishing Shampoo feels so creamy and luxurious. You'll feel a softness that shines through. New Formula Organics, for softness that shines through.
Hey, is your film as easy to load as this? Hardly. Can your camera take different picture sizes whenever you want? Oh, shame. How about an index print that makes it this easy to order reprints? No, thought not. You don't just need a new camera. What you need is an advanced photo system like Kodak Advantix. It's a different kind of film and a different kind of camera. Together, they can help you take pictures further.
So what did he say?
Really?
Oh, hold on, there's another call. Oh, hi, Simon. How was the match?
Fine. Look, just tell Dad it's an emergency.
With BT's call waiting service, okay. For just £4 yeah, a quarter, okay. You'll always know when someone's trying to get hold of you.
Trace, when are we meeting?
And if you get call waiting now, it's half price for the first 6 months.
Oh, I forgot. Can you pick Simon up on the B334 and take some clothes? Night.
Because one day, it might really be an emergency.
Oh, my sister wouldn't let me down.
Ove Waldner of Sweden, the world number two, the former champion, up against the young upstart who's swept all before him
second game,
so far, but he's again down here.
One love. He starts where he left off, strong forehand topspin to take the first point.
Although Pong is an electric player, Samsonov seemed to have more time against him. He's got no time here against Waldner.
I think the crucial difference is that Waldner has the ability to vary until the last possible second to vary where he's going to put the ball. And Samsonov just can't anticipate here as well as he did against Kong Lung Ho. Varies the point of contact all the time between bat and ball, capable of playing any shot in the book.
Normally there's a serenity about Samsonov's play, but he's having to check himself and stab at shots. It's very unlike him, and Waldner's keeping him guessing all the time. 1-4. Waldner, quick to apologise, just getting a flick off the net.
Return, not quite good enough from Waldner. A better short return there from Waldner, just kept it tight. Samsonov did the right thing, he tried to get in, but it was just that little bit too tight. Again, a little bit of topspin on the service. And Samsonov topspinning off the end of the table. Again, it's Waldner who gets in, it's Waldner who puts the pressure on, forces the error.
Well played, Samsonov. More resilient defending from him there.
Shot by Samsonov down the line into Waldner's backhand. Waldner just not quite topspinning strong enough there, but what a great shot down the line.
Oh, yes.
6-10.
His mind is totally in gear now with what Samsonov's trying to do.
Again, the big backhand stops in there, this time just missing. Waldner knows he has to go for it, so he's not worried. He'll continue to do that.
Oh, yes. It was a point that had everything. Stunning forehand topspins, and then the devilish disguise on the drop. Missed the point there. Isn't that amazing return? He completely changed his return.
Mit 8 Kilometer.
Backhand on the diagonal, forehand whip down the line.
Sasnov,
well, spin.
Figures that he made Valder miss there.
Strong top spin there.
13, 10.
Into Samsonov's back on. This time, though, it had to go down the line. Volner punishing Samsonov in the backhand corner.
Samsonov seems determined to play the majority of it to Valdner's forehand. But he's coming a cropper with this tactic.
I think possibly he's thinking that from the forehand side, Volner has less deception. From the backhand side, Volner really can put the ball anywhere. But at least when he's playing forehand from the forehand side, you've got a better chance of predicting where the ball's going. But as you say, up until this point in time, it's not really working for him.
3 points adrift as serve changes.
Well,
the serve that Kong was finding real difficulty with in the semi-final. Enormously high toss. A let called and so sporting.
Volner there giving the double hit. The ball actually hit his finger and then went on to the bat. And Volner quick to give the point.
Didn't spot that, but very sporting of Valder.
And now Samsonov scored up.
14-4.
Up on a roll now. Suddenly the serve is proving just what he wants, and he's picking up so many with his third ball. Five out of five for Vladimir Samsonov on his serve, and suddenly he's found a weakness in Valdner. For how long? Valdner can't read his serve at the moment. Trails by two.
Great rally, and the topspin into the backhand wins the point.
16.
Brilliant Samsonov is, however much of a problem he has with the Belarusian serve, Valdner stays confident.
And the error there from Samsonov, he had every chance to make that topspin.
Stops the runner, 3 points with serve. Switch of attack from the Swede.
Right round on the backhand side there, Volner playing the forehand topspin. I really do feel now that Samsonov is just beginning to read a little bit better where the ball's going. So this is a very, very important sequence of serves.
Remember, it was 5 out of 5 for Samsonov. Last time he served, if he does it now, he's going to level up at a game each. But there's the confidence of Alnett. He misses 5 serves on the previous sequence and then goes cracking in on this.
It really is a fine example of you don't worry about what's happened in the past, you focus on what's about to happen.
Incredible. His strengths become his weakness.
But the service invited that sort of treatment.
Maybe he was thinking about it, and look at Waldner now. He knows what he's just achieved. One more point will do it. One more game will do it. He's 2 games up. And that's just in case they don't want to look. But Waldner looking in very good nick and showed tremendous competitiveness there.
I thought at the end there, 18-17, 17-18 with Samsonov serving. His serves were just a little bit loose. He allowed Waldner to make the topspin.
So Waldner, a game away now, just 1 game away from his 2nd world title.
Hit the jackpot on Sky in June with premiere movies.
Look at this place. It's made of money.
Robert De Niro, Sharon Stone, and Joe Pesci, Casino. Patrick Swayze and Wesley Snipes to One Foo.
Have you ever beaten a prisoner?
No.
Christian Slater and Kevin Bacon, Murder in the First. Michael Douglas and Annette Bening, The American President. Stallone and Banderas.
Today I become number one.
Assassin. Live sport in June includes the British Lions tour of South Africa. Both hemispheres compete for Super League's World Club Championship. And Tiger Woods takes on all comers in golf's US Open. New to Sky One. Corbin Burnson on board the shuttle in the Cape.
He becomes anything he wants to be.
The Pretender. And coming soon.
I'm a sheep pig.
Babe.
Do I have something in my teeth?
Ace Ventura, When Nature Calls. Tune in to Sky from June.
I dare ya.
Now you've got a good reason to dance and be happy. Mega Jukebox is here. If you're quick, you can get 200 original hits from the 50s, 60s, and 70s, the good old days. The songs are here together on 10 CDs for an amazing price. So get pen and paper ready.
Mega Jukebox, a collection of hit songs that bring back memories at a price that makes you want to dance.
Summer in the city, poetry in motion.
Gracious, great balls of
fire. Mega Jukebox can only be purchased from TV Shop. So call and order 200 hits on 10 CDs for an unbeatable price. Call now.
Morning.
Morning, Dad.
Oh, yeah. I must sort out that loan. But I can't get to the bank.
Hello!
There's a new convenient way to get an unsecured personal loan.
Call Lombard Direct. Free on 0800 215 000. 24 hours a day.
We have loans from £800 to £15,000 for almost anything, and our rates are low.
One call to Lombard Direct, and you're laughing.
To arrange a loan or for more information, call free on 0800 215 000.
So far, the Masters given the youngster a bit of a lesson. 2 games to love. Samsonov needs all his brilliance and all his composure now if he's going to make a match of this. Samsonov to begin the 3rd game. Samsonov's had a reputation of being the runner-up,
in fairly important competitions. If he's the runner-up here, it might begin to nag at him.
2-1.
He's only a young player, I think we have to keep that in perspective. But having said that, I think you're absolutely right. Until you win that first major title, there always has to be that nagging doubt. We know he's a great player, we can see that. But he still has to notch up that first major victory. And I'm sure that then will open the door and we'll see many, many great victories from him. But as yet, he's still got to win the big one.
Three, two, one. Four, two.
Now it's Valdner who's picking up cheap points on his serve.
Four.
Should have made that though.
Four, three.
Great topspin into the body of Samsonov there. Samsonov totally cramped up.
Six, three.
Samsonov having problems with the Valdner serve. Good service. Samsonov had to push it back. Seven. He wasn't sure of the spin. Valdner straight in with the top spin. Samsonov blocks off the end of the table. 4 out of 5 there with the service.
Interesting, he's reverting to the backhand again.
Let service, both players agreeing.
Well, he might be advised to go for the long toss one. Now, backhand just wasn't working at all. Beginning to take him apart.
Forehand smash there as opposed to the normal forehand topspin.
Four, nine.
Valdner has a reputation in this situation. He's 2-0 up, he's going well in the third just to take the pressure off a little bit. But I can't believe he'll do this in the world final.
And if he does, that's the kind of shot that awaits him.
The service, preventing Valdner getting with that sort of topspin. Amazing shot down the line. Little Samsonov can do. He must be positive on return of serve. He did his best, but what a shot from Valdner.
Oh. And he looks back at his coaches as if to say, do you see that? Let's see it again. Got to be careful he doesn't get carried away. He's too experienced a customer, surely, to do that. But he's after the flashy serve, he's lost 2 points soon after. He's got to control himself.
You just wonder, don't you, whether that is the case. He definitely grinned at the bench and then lost the next 2 points. But he's straight back.
Last 3 or 4 minutes, he's had a fairly stunned expression, Samsonov. 2 good points there. He's taken an old-fashioned mauling from Valdner, but he's not dead yet. And maybe he can provide something right here. 3 points in a row. Extraordinary control.
14-11. Drilled that backhand down the line. A great shot.
Valdner, 3 points to the good. Yeah. I think it was off his body as well. That's why he stood still. Not that Valdner worried. Just takes aim and fires.
Samsonov just toweling a bit of sweat off the table, and this really is the crucial time for Samsonov. He has had enormous problems containing Voldner's serve. Much better. He might as well be positive, be brave, go for the positive return.
And he did there, got it deep, didn't he? But still, Voldner gets a winner off it. And again, that part of the table is his own.
This is a great shot down the line for the second consecutive time. Aces Samsonov down the line.
Well, that's the last thing Samsonov needed. Voldner signals his luck. And he's now 3 points away from regaining his title. Just off.
13-19.
Oh, incredible shots from Voldner. And now he has 7 match points
13-20.
For the world title. What a fish, what a man. Voldner is the king once more. An amazing performance from Jan Ove Voldner. You have to feel sorry for Samsonov. He didn't fire today like he did against Kong, but he wasn't allowed to. Voldner was the governor from the moment they started until the moment they finished. Samsonov may be worried that this is another aspect of a trend of him being the runner-up, but anybody in the world would be the runner-up to Jan Ove Voldner today. And here's the reaction from the Swedish contingent. He nearly did him an injury. Fabulous performance, Dom.
Outstanding performance. What more can you say about this great player? I think the reel, from a technical point of view, he served exceptionally well. Samsonov had problems returning the serve, and he had no problems at all with Samsonov's serves in comparison, and truly the greatest player in the world at this point in time.
Well, here was the moment when he regained the title that he first won in Dortmund 8 years ago, and his reaction even more emotional than it was then. Samsonov, very quick to come across, a brilliantly talented young man, and his time surely will come. He has too much talent not to be the world champion. But Voldner, who has achieved everything, the most successful table tennis player in the men's game in the modern era, and he has now won the world title again.
I think the question mark over Voldner coming into the tournament was, is he past his best? And anybody asking that question is under no doubt as to what the answer is.
So it's been a tournament dominated by China. They've won 6 out of 7. But the final event has gone to Europe and to the best men's player in living memory, Jan Ove Voldner.
Men's singles world champion and gold medal winner, Jan Ove Voldner, Sweden. To present the Surprise Prize to the world champion, the president of the English Table Tennis Association, Johnny Leach, MBE.
Johnny Leach, the last English winner of this trophy, hands the World Championship trophy to Jan Ove Waldner.
And to present the gold medal, Xu Yinchen, President of the International Table Tennis Federation and a former men's doubles champion of the world.
A proud moment. And it's difficult to contemplate Waldner retiring if he's playing as well as he is at the moment. Maybe he'll be on the top of the podium again.
I don't think he'll retire, although I'm sure a lot of players would like to see him retire. I think we'll see a few more years of Jan Ove Waldner.
And here's perhaps the one guy who really would love him to retire. Vladimir Samsonov, silver medalist, his best world championships. And who knows, in 2 years' time, it could be his turn to be where Waldner is right now.
Bronze medal winners, Yan Sen, China, Kong Ling Hui, also of China.
Interesting that China don't take the gold again. They got it last time with
and
Kong.
To present the medal to Yan
there he
Sen
is.
Is Nils Bergstrom,
but
Continental
in the last
Vice President for
three
Europe.
Three times before that, it was European. Persson, Waldner, Gatien of France. So it's far from a Chinese lock-in, the men's singles.
To present the medal to Kong Ling Hui is the Lord Mayor of Manchester, Councillor Derek Shaw. Presenting the flowers to the medalists is Mr. Kimiko Tomas, Butterfly.
So what happens to Waldner over the next few weeks? He can relax a little bit before the season begins again?
I'm sure he will, although the season, like in many sports, is getting longer and longer, and the Bundesliga, although players now will be signing contracts for next season and teams, and I'm sure Waldner now will be hot property. In fact, he'd be hot property prior to this. But the Bundesliga now starts as early as August, so they'll probably take a break and then start the preparations for next season.
To present the Ogimura Cup is Yukinobu Sato, Vice President of the Japanese Table Tennis Association. The Ogimura Cup is in honour of Ichiro Ogimura, a former president of the International Table Tennis Federation and one of the few players in the world to have won a complete set of world titles.
Magnificent trophy.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the national anthem of Sweden?
And so 8 years after he first lifted the world singles title, Jan Ove Waldner becomes world champion once again. And Colin Wilson, I mean, that was just almost a ritual destruction in the end of Samsonov, wasn't it?
It was. Yanovi Voldner, most talented player in the world, and knowing how good Samsonov is, I think that's probably the best display of table tennis that's ever been seen.
And bearing in mind that there's, what, a 10-year gap between the two of them, it really was a master in action, and Samsonov could just watch and learn.
Samsonov was the apprentice on the evening. In the last round, Samsonov put out the world champion Kong Linghui, the best Chinese player in the world, and Voldner just took him apart.
There really aren't many words that you can find new words to describe.
Here, he's just reading everything that's happening. He actually gave Samsonov the forehand loop, basically said to him, you play it anywhere, and when it came, he just counter-attacked it with some topspin, and Samsonov just didn't expect it back again so quickly.
It was difficult to see where Samsonov was going to start getting points, because he was just overawed, really, by that first game.
That's right. The first game was very easy, and Voldner was very much in control. There's one tactic that Samsonov did have, and we've seen that increasingly, which is players playing wide of the opponent's backhand.
Well, here we can see he's playing to Voldner's backhand here, and really these were the only chances that he was getting.
The only hole in Voldner's game was there when Samsonov's playing his forehand attack from his backhand side and playing the ball not into Voldner's backhand, but wide of the backhand. And that's a trend that we've seen in this championships. Previously, players would have played into the backhand and been satisfied, but now people's backhands are getting so much stronger, you have to go wide of the backhand.
Mm. What do you think Samsonov can learn from this? I mean, presumably he's going to have a lot to learn now.
Yes, I think what he needs to learn is anticipation. I was going to say before the match that possibly Samsonov is a danger because he has such good anticipation, but I think we've seen an extra level of this in Voldner's game, and Samsonov has to go away again and learn to take balls where he doesn't know quite where the ball's coming. Anticipation is the key.
Because literally everything he threw at Voldner was coming straight back, wasn't it?
Everything that Samsonov threw, Voldner had anticipated before he'd done it. And there you can see Voldner just taking control.
Oh, yes.
Plays one side, plays the other side, plays a drop shot, and Samsonov, even though he's a very tall guy, there was just he couldn't cover the ground.
It has been, what, 8 years since he last won his world title. He's done it for the second time. How does he keep that accuracy, that speed, that power, that fantastic all-round game of his over those years and come back and win a world title for a second time?
I think rather like Deng Yaping, the key to it is just an absolute determination to be the top. And he's just determined to dominate the world in table tennis. He wants everyone to know that he is the best player, and today he proved it.
Well, we've seen some of the strokes that he was playing against Samsonov, but at times his serving was truly awesome.
That's right. If we watch here, Voldner just serves Samsonov off. It's incredible.
And he's almost making him look foolish, and Samsonov is no fool.
No, that's exactly what he's trying to do. He wants to entertain as well as to dominate. He wants to demonstrate to Samsonov that he's better than him. And on that occasion, he served and he aced him by the width of the table, 5 feet.
Now, Voldner is already a millionaire from the game of table tennis. He's got a very good living out of it. But presumably he's going to have won over a lot of new fans now who never really saw him when he won his world title back in 89.
That's right. It's 8 years since he was world champion. He has done other things and won everything else. But I think to win the world championships again, that will just give him a whole new set of fans and a whole lot more money.
Well, a tremendous win there for Jan-Ove Voldner. He becomes the world men's singles table tennis champion for the second time in his career. Well, there were three doubles finals played today. We'll see if Voldner succeeds in the men's doubles a little later on to lift his second world title, perhaps. But first of all, we're going to show you what happened in the mixed doubles final. Now, here, Deng Yaping had a chance to make it three titles in this world championships when she partnered Kong Linghui against another Chinese pairing, the Olympic champion Liu Guoliang and Wu Na.
Czechoslovakian Table Tennis Association.
And so the trophy was lifted by Liu Guo Liang and Wu Nan. Colin Wilson, it's nice to see Liu Guo Liang get something out of this tournament because he went out of the men's singles fairly early on.
That's right. He's the Olympic champion. He's a wonderful player. He had some superb matches in the team event, but he was beaten in the team event. He then went out of the singles very early, but it's nice to see him get something from the championships.
Well, on to the women's doubles final. Well, Deng, as you saw there, defeated in the mix, but she still had a chance in the women's doubles. She partnered Yang Ying against the partnership of Li Ju and Wang Nan, also from China. Well, Deng and Yang won the first two games, but they lost the next two, so it all went to a deciding game, and that's where we join the action.
Game. Long,
so,
long.
Deciding game.
Lee.
It's Lee to serve to Deng.
One, long. One, one.
Deng punched that hard there. The long pimpled surface on her backhand. Ball comes through very flat, very difficult to play against.
One, two. Two, two.
Another strong forehand from Wang. She really has immense control on the shot. Well, they had a dead and buried. No way Wang could get back for that. She was marooned. You can see it. The far side of the table. She wasn't going to get back in time. They got in each other's way. Deng had a real chance.
Good return to serve there from Wang. She pushed it wide to Yang's forehand. Took her by surprise, smashed the ball in the net.
Sharpness about her reactions now when the points go her way. That little skip in the air. Mentioned about the adrenaline factor. It looks like she might be getting it back. The alarm bells have rung. Oh, yes. Fantastic reactions. A little lucky, but she reacted very well indeed.
Went for the block, and then she recovers, smashes down the line. Good reactions there.
Oh, five.
Heavy backspin serve, Wang Nan pushes in the net.
Five, six.
Constant advice now from Deng to Yang.
Again, an uncharacteristic error from Deng Yaping. By her standards, that was a comparatively easy forehand down the line.
Six, seven.
Li Ju had a good chance there, in position, but just overhitting.
turn there. Long fast push into Li Ju's backhand. Force the error.
Nine, six, young.
It's interesting that both Wang and Li give their service signals way, way before they do the serve, and yet when Deng does it, it's a split second before, almost like she's making up her mind at the very last moment. It hardly gives Yang much time to just get her brain in gear. Wang gives more time. Wang gives more time for Deng.
10-6.
Good long fast serve there.
Please.
Yes, been told to get on with it.
10-7.
Good return.
Seven. Yes,
the frustration evident, but they're beginning to work really well again, are Yang and Deng. Ominous signs. Body language very good from the more experienced pair. And again,
12-7.
They're moving up, not just one gear, but probably two.
Great use of the angles, wide to the forehand, wide to the back, and then the smash across the table. Excellent play by Deng Yaping and Yang Ying.
They lead by five. Yes. Excellent
eight,
smash from Li.
12, one.
Li very quickly round, takes the time, top of the bounce, and the smash into Yang's body.
There's every point now given the absolute most from these two. Yes, you sense the momentum has swung for the last time.
Deng Yaping, not the sort of player to let anybody off the hook.
The largest lead of the game. And it's growing all the time. Pick up a point for love of money. Yes, first point that they got though off Wang's serve. And you sense that the damage is done.
Good shot by Li Ju. Best tactics now for Li and Wang, just relax. Go for the big shots, nothing to lose. And who knows, if they go on, then they could still get back in to this fifth and final game.
Beautiful defending.
was a great block by Deng Yaping, and of course off the long pimple surface the ball comes through that little bit slower, it drops, and Li Ju didn't have the pace on the ball to make the shot, to make the fast topspin.
And the forehand from Wang, which has been so good for much of this match, is nowhere close now. The shake of the head summed up what's happened in the last 3 or 4 minutes.
19-10.
Yang there, an excellent topspin down the middle of the table.
What a miss. 20. And it's set up 10 match points, 10 points for the title for Yang here and Deng.
Only just missed, and a look of disbelief on her face.
Well played.
21.
It was more difficult than they thought, and I think more difficult than anyone thought, especially after they've taken a 2-love lead. All credit to Li and Wang for coming back, but Deng has won another title. What a woman she is, and good to see her wreathed in smiles now. Yang has played her part as well, particularly in the middle of the match where Deng just seemed to lose her form. But there's the congratulation, and she's won the women's doubles title for the third time, and it's her second world title of today. Women's singles champion, and now with Yang Ying, women's doubles champion as well.
And that, of course, makes it 3 world titles at this World Championships for Deng Yaping. Colin Wilson, it wasn't an easy stroll for her and Yang Ying in this one, though.
No, I think this one could have gone either way. Obviously, it takes two, and Deng Yaping is one half of the partnership. I was particularly pleased for Yang Ying, who's ranked 4 in the world, her partner. She went out early in the team in the singles, losing to a French woman, and it was nice to see Yang Ying getting a gold medal too.
In both those doubles finals that we've seen so far, it's nice to see the movement around the table, isn't it? It's a different game to the singles.
That's right. It's very much a tactical game. And you can see here just the speed at which they move and the way they get out of each other's way in order to play the next shot. That's some fantastic movement. But they do live together, they train together in China, and because of that, they do tend more to spend more time playing doubles in training, and that's why they're the best doubles players in the world.
And so the understanding between them is extremely good before they even get to the table.
That's right. They know what their partner's going to do, they know what their partner's thinking, and they know how to cover the angles to make life easier for their partner.
OK, so that was the women's doubles final. We're going to move on to the final, the men's doubles now. And Jan-Ove Voldner and his Swedish teammate Jorgen Persson were up against Kong Linghui and Liu Guo Liang of China. The Swedes went 2-1 up, so we're going to join it at the start of the fourth game.
Persson serve, double.
This is the first World Championships when the doubles has actually been the best of 5 for some time. The best of 5 was introduced from the quarter-final, semi-final and final. So under previous rules, the Swedish pair would have actually won the title, but the best of 5 now, they need one more game.
What was interesting, Matthew was pointing it out, was the number of points won against serve in that last game after 2 games where serve was fairly dominant.
Of course, in doubles, the service is less effective than in singles because you can't have deception with direction. You have to serve into the same half of the table. So you're then limited to variation in spin and, of course, speed, the long, fast one. You can't serve down the line and catch them out and so on. So I think once they get used to reading the spin, they don't have to worry about deception in direction. The serve arguably becomes less important in doubles than it is in singles.
Oh yes, off the edge, Kong signifies he was lucky, but at this stage they'll take it.
Five. 2.
That was a great touching from Pearson down the line.
Two have already been through the mill, remember, the Swedes, beating Matsushita and Shibatani in the fifth game, 21-18, after dropping 8 match points, but they finally clinched at 21-18, so they're used to this kind of match.
So it takes Fandler.
Kong and Liu came through without any problem at all. A surprisingly easy win against Jean-Philippe Gatien and Damien Elwar, France. Three love.
5-6.
Again, down the line. Not as much pace from Pearson, but he spun the ball up in the air and the block off the end of the table.
5-7.
These two suffered such setbacks individually in the singles event. Determined to get gold here.
6-7.
Kong Ling Hui there, going for the big backhand topspin. Spectacular table tennis when Pearson and Volden are away from the table. They'll certainly lose more points than they win. It's very important that they get up to the table and dominate the rally, like the Chinese pair did on that occasion.
10-6.
Kong obviously disappointed to lose yesterday in the mixed doubles final with Deng Yaping. Liu was the man who picked up gold with Wu Na.
11-6.
So one gold already. Is he going to have the second here?
11-7.
Again, the backhand topspin, Kong Ling Hui. Struck it hard, it struck it off the end of the table.
And both of them, of course, have gold from the team event.
12-7.
Brilliant combination there. The popped up return and then the crushing third shot.
13,
and you just feel in this game the Swedish pair have backed off the table perhaps a little too easily. Having said that, the Chinese pair have stayed close, put them under a lot of pressure and forced them away.
There's a face that fears the worst.
8-13.
Beautiful flick from Waldner setting up the shot. Tikkan Carlsen watches on. Look at the intensity in his face. Shot.
8-14.
Soft and tougher for the coach. He's been out there, he's done it, he's won this title. 1985. And he's as keen to win as the players, but he can't do a great deal now.
15.
Terrific return from Gong Sai Jinhua, the Chinese coach.
8-16.
And they've lost it just for the moment. They're 8 points adrift. But Valder gets the flick.
That was a tremendous shot. Totally relaxed. And a rocket backhand topspin down the line. Superb play.
17-9.
Well, for me, Waldner doesn't look like a guy who's holding back and waiting for his singles. He's absolutely committed to this.
17-10. China! 17-11.
disguise there by Vollner. It looked like it was going down the forehand. Last minute change down the line.
17-12.
Again, the spinny forehand from Vollner wins the point.
Still in it. It hasn't gone away yet for Sweden this particular game.
And of course now Vollner with his serves. Short over the net.
13-20.
And they've raced away now to 7 game points. And they've wrapped it up straight away. A wonderful flourish at the end there from Korn and Liu. And we've got a deciding 5th game to this men's doubles final. Sweden twice going in front with Vollner and Persson, and twice China have come back with Kong and Liu.
A preview of the Kleenex for Men Tissues movie presentation.
Nationalist leader Vladimir Rodchenko denounced the U.S. pressure as an act of war.
The Cold War may be a memory.
Maybe it's not as bad as it looks.
But the missiles still wait under the waves.
It is.
Trouble in Russia! They called us!
We're here to preserve democracy, not to practice it.
Now, miles from home.
Seal a goddamn bay before we all go down!
In the deep, vast middle of the sea.
There will be a nuclear holocaust beyond imagination.
A fearful decision has been demanded.
This is the captain. Release of nuclear weapons has been authorized.
The unthinkable is unfolding.
This is not a drill.
Armageddon is once more just a shot away.
Torpedoes in the water bearing 048!
Mr. Hunter, I'm captain of this boat. I've made a decision.
We cannot launch our missiles unless both you and I agree.
Arrest this man and get him out of here!
Gene Hackman.
Give me the missile key, Mr. Hunter.
Denzel Washington.
Snapshot 2 and 4. Now, everyone!
Tony Scott's Crimson Tide, coming soon to the movie channel.
Impulse ID.
Personal natural extracts. I smell orange, I smell rosemary, I smell eucalyptus.
And I smell a rat.
Monty Python and I have a very intimate relationship. When John says an alpha something completely different, I have to admit I tend to get stirrings. Longings, you know, that have to be satisfied.
Sorry about that.
These children might not be yours, John, but they wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you.
Now for something completely, completely different.
Dennis?
Paramount Comedy Channel, Friday night, every night.
Sort out that loan, but I can't get to the bank.
Hello!
There's a new convenient way to get an unsecured personal loan.
Call Lombard Direct, free on 0800 215 000. 24 hours a day.
We have loans from 800 to 15,000 pounds for almost anything, and our rates are low.
One call to Lombard Direct, and you're laughing.
To arrange a loan or for more information, call free on 0800 215 000.
Thank you.
Fifth and final game. Do you
deciding
disturb?
Game. Liu Guoliang to serve to Yana Vivalda.
Just one.